We welcome all to the program of Voice for Public Sector, a YouTube channel of General Insurance Employees Association, South Zone. Comrade J. Gurumurthy, Senior Leader of General Insurance Employees and All India Insurance Employees Association is with us. Is the most competent person who can give clarity on the issues pertaining to general insurance industry as well as the issues pertaining to workforce of these general insurance companies. I welcome Comrade Gurumurthy for this program. First of all, I wish to focus the burning issue among the general insurance employees. For the last more than 4 years, general insurance officers and employees are waiting for their wage revision. No forward movement is there on that issue. What is your assessment on the situation prevalent in general insurance industry, and how to take forward the movement for fulfilling the aspirations of the general insurance employees?
Thank you. I wish Voice of Public Sector all success, and I am told it is the 100th episode of the Voice of Public Sector communications. Greetings to all of you, all the viewers, especially from insurance fraternity. You asked a question very relevant and very contemporary. The employees and officers are seriously agitating on the issue of long pending wage revision. It is pending for more than 50 months, due from 1st August 2017. The officers and employees are eminently entitled for a very fair wage revision, as assured by the then chairman of GIPSA, at par with LIC of India. And it is unfortunate that this issue is getting delayed for over 48-50 months without any knowing to the unions, especially the check-off qualified unions. It is not good for any institution to ask the employees to work on the same wages for 10 years. The last wage revision was effective from 1-8-2012, and we are entering 2022. For 10 years, it is not good for any organization to keep the employees on the same scales of pay. So there is urgent need to settle this issue of wage revision, so that the new initiatives of these public sector companies are taken forward to bring better results for the economy. They are talking about solvency issue for delaying the process of wage revision. Unfortunately, these issues are discussed in social media not only by the aggrieved employees but also by some of the management personnel also. That is very unfortunate. Why should a chairman or an executive of an insurance company should go to the Twitter and tell the employees that one company is better placed and the other companies are not so? Why create a wedge between one company to another company? That's not fair. And the unions are very responsible. They have created unity. 100% unity of employees are there. They are very reasonable, and whatever agitation they are undertaking these days are not hurting the business aspect of this institute. Wonderful. They are asking, they are conveying their anguish and anger without hurting the business interests of the organization. The government and the companies should ponder over on this. All the PSGICs and GHRE are doing exceedingly well, excepting a hiccup for some time. The reasons are varied. The government was not cooperating with the public sector. What is expected of this government? DFS, Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance. They are supposed to fill up the vacancies of chairman, CMDs of the company, directors of the company, they were not doing on time. There has always been a time gap between a vacancy arising and the actual date of posting of the new CMD. And whoever is posted, the tenure was also very small. So this has also impacted in the servicing or direction part of this public sector insurance company. One. Second, the government created uncertainty by their shifting policy stance. They were talking about merger of three companies. Unions accepted. Unions asked for merger of all four companies into one. But the government said, now three companies, later we will consider all the other company, four companies together, no issue. And this was going for 2 years, 3 years. Committees are appointed, money was spent on consultation, but ultimately, suddenly, the government decided we are shelving that merger process. Again, we are going to sell one of the public sector companies. Very bad. So, inconsistent approach of the government also created uncertainty on the management level, and which impacted on concentrating on business development. And another aspect is, IRDA has been tightening the regulations, especially in the matter of provisioning for IBNR. So we had to provide more money towards IBNR. To my mind, that is now optimum level is reached. So henceforth, that liability will not be carried forward. That will not be addition to IBNR. In fact, the IBNR provision will slowly come down when the companies start reviewing the claims and reducing that provision. This is one aspect. Companies are taking care. And as I said, that final option liability is also going to be cleared in a year or two. So these are all passing things. That is not going to be a permanent strain on the balance sheet. But yet, why the government should talk about there is loss, there is solvency issue? It is not making of the employee or the management. I have already explained. So what is to be done now? Now, somebody was telling the government, how can they pay the, what you call, arrears? We should not put ideas into the mind of government. The employees are entitled. It is overdue payment for you. The company should have given provision in the balance sheet. They say provision could not be given in the balance sheet because there was not a percentage offer. There was no percentage offer. Had there been a percentage offer in April 2019, when the then chairman Jipsa was indicating a very fair wage revision, because of intervention of what you call it, this Lok Sabha election in 2019. So these are not the issues of the management or the government making for which employees clearly are not responsible. Now what is needed is capital infusion, even without wage revision. They say we want money to pay, give you the wage revision. We want money to pay you the wage arrears. That is simply unacceptable. What is needed today is capital infusion. Perhaps each company, at least three of the companies, National, perhaps a little more, United India and Oriental, around from 3,000 to 4,000 crore each company should require capital infusion. That is your legitimate expectation. In all private companies, capital infusion is taking place. Why capital infusion cannot come in the public sector? Because these are the areas where IRDA is asking more and more tightening provisions. The government should have infused capital. What they did in the last 2 years, they announced some 2,500 crore in the 1920 budget, and they gave 2,500 crore on the last working day, last day of the year, 31-3-2020. What is the use? Only you can show it in the balance sheet that I have solvency just to meet the requirement of IRDA. What we need is capital infusion to empower the companies to do major business. Unless you are empowered to do major business, you cannot bring profit for the insurance. There should be a premium growth to take care of the solvency margin ratio. there should be profitability, which will come only when you are empowered to take mega risk, which the company could not do in 1920 earlier, because they gave a lesser money. In 1920-2021 also they gave some money. Major part of that money came only on 31st March 2021. So this is very bad on the part of the government. Perhaps the management should ask for a more functional autonomy to the respective company. Had this capital infusion, what was given earlier, came on time, like New India, like GACD, for them there was no need for put money into the companies, because they went for IPO, and New India got around 1800 crore capital infusion by way of IPO in 2017, 1 year ahead of the expected major strain on balance sheets by OMOP and other things. So they got in advance, they had that advantage of keeping their market share and going all out in the market, which other companies were handicapped. GAC Re got a capital infusion of 1500 crore in 2017, IPO. But the other companies could have been given, if they had also been given by the government, by the owner, the government of India, perhaps in 2019-20 and 2021, they would have showed a bigger market share, premium growth, and solvency also would have taken care. They have been taking money for 50 years, public sector general insurance companies, from 1971 to 2021. Have we ever gone to the government for asking money to pay the claims? There was Gujarat earthquake, there was super cyclone in Orissa, there was flood, continuous flood in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Uttarakhand. So never ever we went to the government seeking support for making, settling claim. And we have been contributing by of dividend to the government, by way of corporate tax. But today there is a need, because of the circumstances explained, for additional capital infusion. The government can easily give. I think now we need to create pressure. I am very happy. JFTU is taking wonderful effort. Understand? The employees have done wonderfully well. As I was telling somewhere, 300 of our employees have lost their lives during pandemic. The government did not give you, to, they ask you, they permit you to close your offices. They said, whatever be the condition, severe pandemic condition, you will have to keep your office open. You can come in shift, 30%, 40%. And employees were exposed to pandemic situation. 300 employees, active, younger employees, qualified. They have lost their lives serving the nation, I say that. You are also a COVID warrior. You are serving the insurance interests of the people, and government should recognize this fact. Employees highly, eminently deserve wage revision. And what not? Now companies are now rebounding. And somebody said that some one company is bigger. Okay. Fundamentally, all companies are, I say everything is okay, but some company a little stronger. The stronger company was given capital infusion earlier than you, 2 years, 3 years earlier than you. That helped process. Good, very good. Today, I saw one of the balance sheets of what you call 6 months, second Q2 of 21-22, New India, Mr. Atul Sahai himself said, chairman of GIPSA, CMD of New India, very efficient man, dynamic man. Only problem for us is that he is not calling the unions to share the information. He is choosing social media to share the information. They are check-up qualified unions. 30 months after April 2019 till 21, how many months? So for this, for 2.5 years, 19, 20, 20, 21, 2.5 years, no discussion with the unions. One is wage revision. There is, even beside wage revision, are there not issues about the industry? Today you are talking about closure and merger. It's no, wrong. And you take a target. Should it come along with wage revision at the end of the year? Why this knee-jerk reaction? That is very bad. Now, what we should demand is, there may be ups and downs in all the balance sheets, including New India. Remember, some employees were asking, sir, New India, all companies should be merged together. That is our demand, very clear. We should fight about on the government decision of selling a company. We should fight. Today, all the company, public sector, general insurance, we take contingency. Our job is to ensure contingency. Contingency may come anytime. Nobody knows. This year, there were 4 CAT losses, according to chairman of GIPSA. New India's balance sheet up to September, Q2, H1, claims out pay out of 2,350 crore, he said. He said this year is going to be a challenging year. New India, their ICR, combined ratio, has gone up from 113 to 121 in 6 months. Their solvency margin has come down from 2.1 to 1.93. So it will happen to any company. And 5-6 years back, New India also, there was a loss. There was a panicky. We said nothing to be worried about that. In insurance, general insurance, the graph will go up and down. And we are strong, understand. We are strong. We have the backing of the government, sovereign guarantee. That backing is not adequate. So what I should say now is, younger employees, you are entitled for wage revision. I know the certain amount of frustration will come. JFT, you're doing a wonderful job, creating 100% unity. Yes, still more push is required. We shall not allow this government. And if management agrees to that, we shall not allow our management to dilute the system of periodical wage revision. They can't take a position and create a rumor. And we should not spread the what you call surmises, conjectures, and guesswork. We should not do that. Based on the, don't discuss. You are entitled, you should get wage revision and you should get arrears of wages. Perhaps this year, if government gives 4,000 crore as capital infusion, some part of the money will be used for that. It is only temporary. That will create more keep up the morale of the employees. On the contrary, if something negative will be thought about by this organization, by the government, we shall resist it. Because we have made this company. So that is what I intend telling you, and you have done very well, and companies are quite doing very well. Only thing is capital infusion, empower my company to do the business. If I do the business, if I retain maximum business, if I earn a profit, again the money is going to the government only. Again I repeat, if they give 4,000 crore to each company as a capital infusion, you are not going to keep that, use the money for wage and means expenditure. For some part you will use for wage. But the entire money, again, coming from government security, from government, it goes to United India balance sheet, it goes to national balance sheet, it goes to Oriental balance sheet, and it will again, from balance sheet, goes to government security only. Where do you keep the money? You will keep the money in government security, central government security, state government security. Only thing is, that money, government money, is going through my balance sheet, so that as per IRDA guidelines, I am safe, solvent, I can go massively in the market. And today, the market is health. Health. Private sector is reducing their health portfolio. Motor portfolio is earning profit. So, motor, they are concentrating, we are concentrating health. And there is unhealthy competition between companies. When I was told that one company has paid a claim of 2,350 crore in 6 months, COVID claim, I am relating it to the what you call madness in the competition between public sector. Why one company, knowing full well that it's loss making, to underwrite, underquote and get that business? So these are all the areas where the unions need to talk to the management. And I am very sure, with the amount of unity we have created, the amount of heat you are generating, we are going to get a very good wage revision. And initially, the keeping silence by the management and the government, that is not acceptable. And very soon, they are supposed to call the unions and share the information and discuss and settle a good wage revision. This is what I want to say. We will be with you. And now, as I am now representing All India Insurance Pension Association. And we from AIIPA, we also give you full support. That is what I guarantee. Thank you so much. Swaminathan, let us continue. Thank you so much.